Hello everybody, today we are going to see our next concept, that is frequency polymer. Okay, next concept is frequency polymer. Okay, before this we have seen how to construct histogram, how to construct bar graph. Okay, after bar graph we have seen histogram. Okay, so there are two types of frequency polymer. One, first one is with the help of histogram, and second without using histogram. Okay, so here we are going to see how to construct frequency polygon with the help of histogram. Okay, so with the help of this example, we will see the first type. Okay, once again, see, we are going to start on frequency polygon. There are two types, with the help of histogram, and second type is without help of histogram or without using histogram. Okay, so first one we are going to see now with the help of histogram. Okay, so see here, for the following data, draw a histogram and a frequency polygon. Okay, both the things here we have to do. So this is which by using histogram or frequency polygon by using histogram. Okay, so see now here, what is given? Marks are given and number of students are given. Okay, 20 to 30, 5, 30 to 40, 12, 40 to 50, 6, 50 to 60, 20 students. 60 to 70, 18 students, 70 to 80, 10 students, 80 to 90, 69, 90 to 100, 3 students are there. Okay. Now, here one important thing is there, intervals. You need to observe intervals. Okay. Intervals are here, continue. Okay. Intervals are continue. 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60. Like that, intervals are given, continuous intervals are given. Understood? So, we need not to do any changes in that. Okay, because if it is discontinuous, then we need to make it continuous. How to continue it, that we have seen. Understood? But here there is no problem because intervals, marks are given in intervals and those intervals are continuous. So directly we can use this information to construct frequency polygon. Okay. Now see here, number of students. Number of students are 5, 12, 6, 20, 18, 10, 16 and 30. Here maximum number is 20. Maximum students are 20 and lowest score is 3. Okay, so according to this we need to show on the y axis. Okay, so now here I am making y axis. Okay, so this is y axis and now we will show here x axis on this. Okay, so now see, y axis minimum is 3, okay, and maximum is 20. So this we need to write like this. So suppose I will take here 0, this is origin, understood? This is 0, 0, 0, both the axis will be 0, 0. So here it will come 2, suppose here you get 2, then here 4, then next 6, then after that 8, then 10, then 12. Then 14, then 16, then 20, sorry 18, and then 20. Okay, like that we have taken what we have taken number of students. So here we can write number of students. Okay, here we can write number of students. Okay, now on x-axis we need to think about the x-axis. Okay, x-axis intervals are given 20 to 30. 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, like that it is given, and so all the intervals are continuous. Okay. So now what we can do here is we need to take see 20, then before 20 it is going to come 10. Understood? So here I can take 10. Okay. So this first I have taken 10, then here next will be 20, then after that 30, then 40, then 50. 60, then 70, 80, then 90, 100, and 110. Okay. See here, then you will ask me, last one is 100, but then why we have taken 110 and this 10? Okay. So, for that also, there is a reason, specific reason. Understood? So, we will see that. Okay. So, now see, 20 to 30. How many number of students are there? 5. Okay, so 20 to 30. number of students are 5. So here 2 plus 4 and here it is going to come 5. So 20 to 13 is it will come here. Number of students are 5. So 5 students we can show this. Okay. Then 30 to 40, how many students are there? 12 students. So 10 and this is 12. So 12 students. This is joined by the means that is stolen. Okay. 12 students are there. Then after that, 6, again 6 students are there. Okay. 40 to 50, 6 students. So here it will come like this. Then after this, 50 to 60 is 20. 50 to 60 is 20. So 20 is here. So you have to use scale. Okay. So here directly. So it will come like this. It is not here, it will come here. Okay, because it is 50 to 60. Okay, 50 to 60. By mistake, I have taken this. So 50 to 60 is 20. So it will come. Okay, then 60 to 70, 18. 60 to 70 are 18. So it will be here. Okay, then 70 to 80, 10. 70 to 80, it will be 10. So we can try this. Okay, then 80 to 90, 60. 80 to 90 are 60. So here 60 will be here. So we need to write this 16 will come. Okay, 80 to 90, 16 are. Then 90 to 30, 90 to 100, 3. 90 to 100, there are 3. So it will be 90 to 100, 3. Understood. So now here our histogram is red. Our histogram is red. Okay. So what we have taken on x axis, this is x axis. What we have taken on x axis? Marks. So we need to denote this axis, whatever we have taken. Okay. So now histogram is ready. What is the question? For the following data, draw a histogram and a frequency curve. So histogram is ready. Okay. Now we need to think about the frequency polygon. Okay. Frequency polygon means we need to join the midpoints. Join the midpoint. What is the midpoint of this 20, 30? Midpoint will be this. This midpoint you will get exactly in the graph paper also. Okay, so this midpoint just I am taking here points. Okay, so this, what is the midpoint of 30 and 40? It will come here. Then 40 to 50, it is here. Then 50 to 60, midpoint. Midpoint is 50 plus 60 divided by 50 plus 60 is 50 plus 60 is 110 divided by 2 is 55. Means that this point will be here. Okay, so that midpoint of this bar is here, this bar is here, this bar is here, and the last bar one is here. Okay, now we got midpoint of these bars. Okay, so just we have to join all the midpoints with a straight line and dotted line with the help of scale and dotted line. Okay, so now I am taking this. Then this, then again now, okay. Okay, so with the help of dotted line we have done this. Understood. Now all the midpoints we have taken with the help of dotted lines. Okay. Now the thing is that this point, this is the initial point, this is the last one. Okay. So this point we need to join to the midpoint of the previous interval. And this is of next interval. Okay. Here interval is 20 to 30. So after that, before that it is 10 to 0 to 10 and 10 to 20. Okay, so here 20, here 10. Here 20, here 10. Understood? So what will be your interval? 0 to 10, 10 to 20, and here your interval is 0. So this we need to join the midpoint of previous, that is A to 20. So it will come here. Okay, A to 20. Understood. And last one will come after that interval is here. And so that midpoint will get on the graph paper. So directly we need to join. Okay, so here frequency polygon is completed. Understood, everybody? Frequency polygon is completed. Means here this frequency polygon is with the help of histogram. Okay, and after this we are going to see that is without using histogram. Okay, so what we have done here, first the given information directly it was given and classes will continue, so directly we can use here. If classes are not continue, then we need to make it continue. Okay, we need to find out its height. Okay, height divided by 2. Then we have seen how to make classes continue. Okay, so with the help of that we need to make classes continue, and after that we have to prepare a histogram with all the given information, and with the help of histogram we need to prepare a frequency polygon by joining its midpoint with the dotted lines. Got it, everybody? Okay, so solve this sum in your notebook and sums from the worksheet also and NCERT textbook also. Okay. Okay, see here students, now we are going to see our next type, that is frequency polygon without using histogram. Okay, before this we have seen frequency polygon with the help of or by using histogram. Now we are going to see without using histogram. Okay, so how to construct frequency polygon without using histogram, that we are going to see with the help of this example. Okay, what is given? Construct a frequency polygon for the following data. Okay, here it is given age in years 0 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, 16 to 20, 20 to 24, 24 to 28, 28 to 32, and 32 to 36. Okay, these are the intervals are given. And number of persons are given 1, 3, 6, 8, 10, 8, 5, 3, and 2. Okay, so when we need to construct a frequency polygon without using histogram, that time we need to convert this into, we need to change it. We need to use this given data in different manner. Understood? So see here, I have constructed here one table. So here first age in years, that all intervals are as it is. And number of persons are given 1, 3, 6, as it is. Whatever it is given, that we have taken. Okay. Now new thing is that class mark. Class mark is nothing but the mean of the class interval. We see here. 0 to 4. What will be the mean of this? So class mark means what? What is mean by class mark? Class mark is equal to lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. The sum of this 2 divided by 2. Okay. So 0 plus 4 is 4. 4 divided by 2 is 2. So what is the class mark of this? 2. 4 plus 8, 12. 12 divided by 2, 6. 8 plus 12, 20. 20 divided by 2 is 10. 12 plus 16. 12 plus 16 will mean 20. 28 divided by 2 is 40. Okay. 16 plus 20, 36. 36 divided by 2 is 80. Okay. This 20 plus 24. Addition, 44 divided by 2 is 22. Okay. Then addition is coming 52. Okay. 52 divided by 2 is 26. Then here it will be 60. 60 divided by 2 is 30. 32 plus 68 divided by 2 is 30. Okay, so these are the class mark. Then you will ask why they are finding class mark. Because here we are not going to construct histogram. So we must know the midpoint. So now what we are going to do? We are going to plot these points. Suppose this is 2, 1. 2, 1 we will plot on this graph. Then 6, 3. After that 10, 6, 14, 8, 18, 10, then 22, 8, then 26, 5, then 33, and then 34, 2. Okay, these points we are going to plot directly. Means you will get the points on the graph. So directly we need to join with the help of dotted lines. Okay, so now these we are going to put.
put on the graph.
Okay, so for that, this number of persons we will show on the x-axis, y-axis. Number of persons we are going to show on the y-axis. Understood? And here on x-axis we will show age. Okay, so this is x-axis and y-axis we are going to use. Number of persons is 1, 3, 6, 8, 10. 10 is the maximum and minimum is 1. Okay, so we can show it properly. So this is 1 we will show. I am taking here 1. Okay, then 2 will be, or here we can take here 0, 1. Here 0, then here 1, then 2, then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, these are we have shown. According to the limit range, we need to spread the information. Okay, so this is 1 to 10 because maximum is 10. So that is over number of students. Here we can give number of persons. Here we can write. Then second one is age. Age is 0 to 4. So 0 suppose I take here, then 4 is here. 0 is origin, it starts from origin. 0, 4, then 6, then 8, then 10. Okay, sorry, 0 to 4, 4 to 8. Okay, it is 4 to 4, then 8, then next one is 12, then 16, then 20, then 24, then 28. Then 32 and last one 36. If you want, you can take 1. No problem. 36 40. Okay. 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, 24, 28, 32, 36, and 40. Okay. Now just we have to put these points on the graph. So first one is 2, 1. 2, 1 is 2 is here and 1 is here. So that point will be here. 2, 1. Then 6, 3. 6, 3 will be 4. Plus 2, 6, 6 will be here, 6, 3, 6, 3 point will be here. Okay, then 10, 10, 6, 10, 6, 10 and 6, 10 and 6 will be here, 10 and 6 will be here. Okay, 8, 6, then 14, and 8 is here. Okay, so that point is here. Then 18, 10, 16 plus 2, 18, 18 will be 10, this is the last one, okay, this is 18, 10, then 22, 8, 22 and 8, 8 will be here, they will meet here, okay, so that point is here, then 26, 5, 26 means here, 26, 5, it will come here, 26, 5, last one 33 is here, 33 and 34, 2, 34, 32, 34, 34, 2, 34, 2 is here. Okay, so now we have plotted all the points, understood? So now we need to join them with the help of straight line or dotted line also you can use. With the help of scale, we need to join it properly. So now, this is over. Still, it is not completed because we need to join it on the axis. Okay. So 0 to 4. So before it will come, we need to join here. It is the origin. Okay. Then after 36 to 40, what is the midpoint of 36 to 40? This will come 38. So we need to join this is to 38. Okay. So this is the histogram without using histogram. Okay. Without using histogram, only one new thing is there. We need to find out its class.
with the help of plasma we can plot very easily, and that we have seen. Okay, so solve this and some examples which are dependent on this. Thank you very much.